Garvey's lenders are queuing up at the Securities Appellate Tribunal seeking a stay on NSDL's move to return shares pledged by Garvey to its actual owners. The move comes at a time when SEBI has mandated the clearing house to return these shares to its owners after Garvey used the power of attorney to move these shares into its own account. The brokerage has subsequently used at least some of these shares to raise funds via pledges. Paswani Upadhyay, she's joining us right now for more. So, you know, obviously there's a lot that's been happening, and now the lenders are queuing up to make sure that their interest is protected.
So what's happened essentially, Devina, since yesterday is that HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank, Bajaj Finance have approached SAT to direct the clearinghouse, that is NSDL, to bring back those shares into the lender's account. And I'm told post-lunch, IndusInd Bank was also sort of joining the fray, you know, before SAT. The broad argument that these lenders are making is that NSDL has transferred these shares from their accounts without their consent, and this is in violation of the Depositories Act. SAT has directed SEBI to hear Bajaj Finance's plea on or before December 4th, and I'm going by what SAT has held for Bajaj Finance. It's likely that the other lenders will also be sent to SEBI to make their case. The third sort of plea that has come before SAT today is of Garvey, which is arguing against the cancellation of its license, and the appellate tribunal has told Garvey to argue its case before NSE's disciplinary committee. So this is what broadly has, you know, happened since morning today. The sense that we're getting from lawyers is, and of course, SAT has not, you know, commented on the merits of the case. Broadly, what lawyers are saying is that, you know, when it comes to the argument, SAT would want to look at the kind of diligence these lenders did before they, you know, lent money to Garvey, whether the shares belonged to Garvey or not, whether it was clients, what kind of diligence did they see, a board resolution, did they see the audit committee resolution before lending this money. So of course, it's very difficult to gauge any of these facts at this stage, and they will be argued before SAT. So this is what, you know, it looks like right now. SEBI on its part, the mandate of the regulator is to protect the interests of public shareholders, which it has done so by passing the interim order November 22nd and, you know, transferred and directed NSDL to transfer the shares back into the client's account. Of course, there are some lawyers who are saying, what are these lenders waiting for since November 22nd? They should have taken the you know, action sooner and gotten a stay from the appellate tribunal, which has now said that the remaining shares should not be touched, and NSDL can't move those shares either to the lender's account or the client's account. So that's the freeze that SAT has directed. Bulk of it has already happened, but, you know, for the remaining one, SAT has given the stay.
Is there precedence to such a case?
Not directly, Devina. You know, the closest case that of late comes to mind is of Allied Financial Services, where SEBI took the call again to protect the interests of the investors, but left the dispute between the parties to, you know, resolve among itself. And that's what SEBI's case is before the Supreme Court, that look, I can't get into whether it was ILNFS's fault or Allied Financial Services' fault. You sort it out between yourselves. I, as a regulator, am mandated to protect the interests of the shareholders. And on its part, SEBI has taken, because, you know, it regulates brokers, so it has frozen Garvey's account. It has restricted it to do any business with clients. So to that extent, SEBI has done what it could at an interim stage until the, you know, results of the forensic audit are out.
That's going to be the key thing to watch out now, what comes out of the forensic audit.
Forensic audit, and also I think banks will have to show, I suppose, before the appellate tribunal that there was no way they would have known, and this is the diligence they did before they lent money to Garvey, and even after all of that, Garvey managed to present the, or, you know, let's say falsify the evidence, and this is all hypothetication. We don't know if any of this happened, but these are probably the facts that would get argued now before SAT.
All right, and we'll keep getting you all those details. I'm sure Paswani will be updating us. Thanks a lot, Paswani, for joining us and taking us through what's happening with the Garvey case.